Hi guys, good evening. Hello guys, good evening. Okay. It's me, friends, and it's been a while since I uploaded a vlog. It's been a while. Maybe it's like more or less 4 months probably. Now I'm back. And this is just to document my new journey and for me to look back one day of this new journey, my new battle in life. And I'm not comfortable. I don't know if I'm really hesitant at first, but I think I'm in this journey for a mission. I feel like I have an obligation and responsibility. Maybe not responsibility, but obligation to share my journey for other people in the same medical condition that I have. I'm so skinny, yes, but I'm okay. I don't know how to start, but yeah, I have my vlog is normally happy vlog. But this one is pretty, it's so different. And yeah, I just want to share, and I want people, especially women with the same battle like I have, to inspire or just share, and maybe they will have the same feelings as I have. Huwag na nga ako mag-English. Nakakapagod. Nakakadrain. Sige. Three months ago, May I hindi pala, June na pala, June 21, I have been diagnosed with cervical cancer stage 3B. How was it detected? Is through biopsy. And last May 31, 2023, I had a biopsy. I had a surgery for to get biopsy and to scrape uterine lining ko, to scrape it. And then the doctor, through ultrasound, nakita nung doctor na I have a mass in my cervix. So, kinuhanan siya ng biopsy during my surgery. And doon nila chinek sa laboratory kung ano yun. And according to the reading, it's carcinoma. Squamous carcinoma. So yun, and so nirefer ako sa oncologist ko, and yun nga na na-confirm na it's cervical cancer stage 3B. So today, this morning, I had my first yung treatment na na-recommend ng oncologist is radiation plus chemotherapy. It's a 25 days radiation plus chemotherapy once a week. So 5 days a week, I'll have my radiation. And once a week, I'll have my chemotherapy. So this morning, nag-start yung radiation ko. And then this Saturday, I will have my first chemo. Yun. So if you're asking, may siguro may mga women out there na curious and lagi nilang tanong, even with my friends, kung anong naramdaman ko nung hindi ko pa nalaman. So, yung symptoms ko were, I had severe cramps, tapos spotting in between my periods, tapos pag mag-sex masakit, and my bleeding after, and then my watery discharge. So yun yung mga symptoms ko on an earlier months, siguro mga 2 years ago. Yun. Pero I just kind of like disregard it, thinking it's just because I'm already 47. So, naramdaman ko siya, I was 45 years old. So, 2 years ago, yung mga spotting in between my periods. Tapos, konting cramps, ganun. Pero normally, wala akong cramps. And then, pain when having sex, yun. Tapos, may bleed siya, may bleeding. Tapos, watery discharge. And then, early this year na siya, 2023, pasakit na ng pasakit yung cramps ko. And I was still thinking it's still part of, baka nagme-menopause ako, dryness, like that. So, yun yung iniisip ko. So, hindi ko siya masyadong inintindi. Tapos, last April, na wala na talagang tigil yung pain. Everyday na siya. So, doon na ako na-alarm. And, yun nga, nagpa-check. And then, nag-ask yung doctor ng laboratory, ultrasound transvaginal. Tapos, yun. Tapos, after ng surgery, yung ultrasound transvaginal, yung first check-up, yun yung in-ask ng doctor. And the doctor asked for the ultrasound transvaginal. And then yun, may nakita na lumps. Ay, mass. Yun yung description doon, mass. So, sa cervix ko. So, yun yung nakita. So, that's why the doctor asked for a biopsy sample. A biopsy para makakuha ng sample to check on the lab. So, yun. Moving forward, so before my before ng first radiation ko, nag-undergo ako ng CT simulation. Yun yung parang CT scan din siya, pero wala lang siya. Hindi ka ipapasok dun sa disc. So parang meron siyang opening. Parang ring lang siya na papasok. So yun yung CT simulation, tapos gagawan ka ng mold sa may, kasi yung part ko is sa puson, so may mold ako dyan, ginawa specifically for me, nagagamitin all throughout the radiation process para hindi mag-move yung balakang ko, kasi pag radiation hindi ka talaga pwedeng gumalaw. Kailangan kasi yung radiation targeted procedure para patayin yung cancer cell with the help of the chemotherapy para palambutin yung ang according to the ano to the explanation of the doctor, yung chemo ko is to help the radiation na ano siya makapenetrate lalo dun sa cancer cell, palalambutin niya. So yun yung explanation sa akin. But then basically yung papatay sa cancer cell is the radiation, targeted na siya. So yun, kung na early detect siya kung nasa pre cancer cell pa ako, siguro posibleng pwede siya sa surgery. Pero since I'm already in a stage 3, target na siya, yun. Para hindi na siya kumalat. So yun. And then aside from this radiation, etong external, etong radiation ko ngayon, after this radiation, this tawag kasi dito external sa labas, plus the chemo. After this, magpapahinga lang ako ng 2 weeks. And then I'm gonna have the brachytherapy. Yung internal naman siya. Yung ipapasok sa loob yung instrument for radiation. Para talagang maano siya. Mapatay siya dun sa pinakamalapit na area. Kasi sa eto lang sa ibabaw yung papatay ng external. So, later on, I will still have external radiation. So, yun. So, itong external ko, 25 days. Tapos, yung chemo ko is 5 session. Yun. If you ask me now kung ang nararamdaman ko, I have been taking pain relievers ever since. Ano, not ever since, pero lately. Ngayon mga ilang linggo na rin kasi nga, because of the pain. The doctor can only give me pain medication for the pain. And sometimes, yung pag may symptoms na ano, na medyo feeling may meron ako infection, so bibigyan ng antibiotics, tapos to help with is mefenamic acid, yung mga ano, pang pain reliever, yun. So meron ako noon. But, so hindi kong mararamdaman this stage yung mga pain. I've been taking pain relievers just to manage the pain. Yun lang yung pwedeng ibigay ng doktor kasi wala namang gamot. Tapos I have vitamins, like 3 klase ng vitamins ako iniinom. So yun. And tomorrow, babalik ako for my second radiation. And natatanungin ko, masakit ba yung radiation? No, wala akong naramdaman pain. If you ask me kung meron akong naramdaman pain, wala. Walang pain so far. Pero I cannot say kung sa katagalan na siya. Kasi syempre, same area yung i-burn ng radiation therapy. Yeah. So, kailangan lang malakas yung katawan, kumain ng maayos, more on fiber. Tapos, ako walang pinagbawal naman yung doktor. Kain daw ako ng kain kasi putot balat na ako. But then he's saying na it's because my body is fighting the cancer. So, talaga, yun pa yung isang concern ko noon. Kasi I was losing weight quickly. Even though hindi ako nagda-diet. Tapos, wala akong exercise. Tapos, hindi ko na kayang mag-sit-ups at push-ups. Talaga, meron na siyang sakit. Sakit na siya doon. So, doon ako talagang magpa-check. So, yeah, that's it for now. And sa mga women out there, early detection is very important. Pap smear, yun. Madidetect siya ng pap smear. So, kung ano kayo na mahal yung pap smear, hindi po. Naririnig ko na yun sa yung mga times na bumabalik ako sa OB ko. So, hindi siya mahal. And sabi naman, hindi naman daw siya masakit. Tolerable naman yung, kasi parang kukuhanan ng maliit na sample sa loob. But it's not painful now. You have, huwag yung antayin na ano, meron kayong maramdaman before kayo magpa-check. Kasi yun na, masakit na yun kasi meron ng something sa loob. Masakit na siya. Kahit yung ultrasound ko na transvaginal, very painful na siya. Very painful. Masakit na masakit. Yun. So, masakit na siya. So, yun. Tapos, may tendency pa na mag-bleed ka kapag meron ka ng, meron na siyang, may something na siya sa loob. Yun. So, it's better na habang bata ka pa or, you know, if you're active sa sex, just have a regular pap smear to check. Oo, kasi sabi naman ng doktor, this type of cancer is hindi naman kasi siya mabilis, mabagal siyang mag-develop. That's why hindi siya na-detect agad. Hindi siya ma-detect agad. Yun. So, learn my lesson na huwag matakot, huwag mahiya, and yun, magpa-check. Alright? I guess that's it for now. And from now on, I think I'm going to have like daily update, like tomorrow, second day. So, please pray for me, and I'll be okay throughout the session, throughout my treatment, medication like that, and see you around next time. Oh, I want to take this opportunity, of course, to thank my friends, first, of course, si asawa ko, DJ, thank you so much for not giving up on me, taking care of me, especially during the first, you know, tayo palang dalawa, we started taking care of me during the early days. For having patience with me, na very ano na ako, like impatient na ako when I'm in pain, you know, and cooking for me, cleaning the house for me, taking care of our dog because I can't. Thank you so much. Thank you for financially helping me, and I wouldn't be able to make it this strong if not because of your support. Also, to my family, mommy, Balot from Australia, who's how do you call that? Anong tawag nun? Nagbenta ng mga plants niya to help financially. Anong tawag yun? May tawag dun? Anong tawag? Hindi ko na alam. Very ano yung mind ko na ngayon dahil sa dami ng gamot. So, putting up a fund me, something like that. No, hindi naman ano. Kasi nagbibenta kasi siya ng mga bulaklak niya dyan sa Australia. Para pang-help ng ano ko, ng to raise funds for my medication, for the therapy, and to Honey Bogues, my sister, and her family as well, for all the prayers, for Joy, our youngest, for the prayer, my mommy is always worried about me. Mommy, I'm okay. See, I'm okay. I'm just skinny, but I'm okay. Everybody who prays for me, my friends, my best friend Marianne, for always cheering me up, to my friends here, Joy, for never hesitate to offer to donate blood for me later on if I need it. Thank you so much, Joy. You are an angel. You never hesitate. You offered right away. And to Doc Kat, who also offered to donate blood, even though we're not, hindi kami magka-blood type. And her friend, I don't know her friend, but she offered. Doc said that her friend also wanted to donate blood for me. Ate Len and her kiddos, who also offered to donate blood for me, and we have the same blood type. I never thought we have the same blood types, because later on the doctor already told me that I might needed to to have a blood transfusion during my 5th week. So that's what the doctor told me. And then my blood type is not easy to find. So kailangan kong maghanap ng donor right away, as early as 2 weeks ago, so that I will know. But I'm hoping, of course, na hindi ko kailangan yun. Kain na ako ng kain. Yeah, sabi naman daw doktor, pag kumain lang daw ako ng kumain, eh, kasi most often than not, eh, magiging anemic daw ako during the radiation and chemo. So, I'm hoping I won't really reach that far. But thank you to those friends who offered. Mahal ko kayo. And nakaka-touch kasi hindi naman tayo, alam mo yung hindi tayo parating nagkakasama, or you know, but you did not hesitate to offer your blood to me, you know, thank you. And but sorry, basta my family, thank you so much. And laking tulong sa nararamdaman ko yung support, all the prayers. Sherry from the US, DJ's best friend, thank you so much for the prayers and for always giving me words of encouragement, and for always for talking to me and for listening and encouragement. And you know, it means so much to me. And to Daisa, thank you so much, Daisa, for helping me, and for now I have somebody to accompany me. And of course, DJ, thank you for driving me to the hospital, and this time it's gonna be every day. And yeah. To sino pa ba, lahat na nagdarasal, Tita Vicky, Mom's friend, Tita di, Mommy Elsa, Mommy Vicky, Mommy Elsa, my best friend's mommy, Auntie Nelia, thank you so much. Everyone, I wouldn't be able to name you, but thank you for including me to your prayers. And you make one happy soul, happy me, get through this. Yeah, I will be continue fighting, and will never be defeated. Thank you. Ayoko na sana umiyak kasi wala namang reason, but it's just, you know, a very appreciative heart of mine. So, yeah, I will keep you posted on how I feel. And don't, to women out there who experience the same, don't be afraid with the rejection. It's not painful, but I'm not gonna say it's not gonna be painful forever. But just be strong. There's wala tayong hindi kakayanin. Tsaka kumain tayo. Listen to your doctors. And yeah, I hope you will get the same support that I'm having. Because I know how difficult it is na walang support. And yeah. Anyway, that's it for now. I'll see you again next time. Bye.